Hi students, I am here to discuss another method of English language teaching, that is audiolingual method. So let us see what is the method and what are the advantages or disadvantages, and when it began, and how it is actually having a great influence on the development of English language teaching. I hope you have been listening to the lectures that are being posted on ELT, of course on the other paper also, that is literary criticism. So let us see what is audiolingual method now. So let me give you an overview of the audiolingual method. So it is a method of foreign language teaching which emphasizes the teaching of listening and speaking before reading and writing. See, till now we have seen different methods of English language teaching, that is like direct method, grammar translation method, and now different approaches also. Now it is the audiolingual method. In this method, what is different from those two is like it emphasizes upon the teaching of listening and speaking. You listen and then you speak. So it uses dialogues as the main form of language presentation and drills as the main training techniques. So in the audiolingual method, dialogues are more important. Language learning is presented in the form of dialogues and also in the form of drills, actually to train the learner, you know, whatever language he is learning. And it discourages the use of mother tongue in the classroom, as we have the the similarity in the direct method. So and to have an overview of the audiolingual method is nothing but a method that emphasizes teaching of listening and speaking more than reading and writing. Actually, you can guess the meaning of audiolingual method, you know, by the title itself. Audio, you all know, is what you hear, and lingua is like a language. Now, cognitive psychologists actually, they say that a children, if he is growing in an environment where a kind of different languages are being spoken, you very easily, okay, very easily and with great facility or with great ease, he or she will be picking up those languages, as many languages as he keeps on listening to, and then speaking in whatever manner it may be, whether it is right or not, as a child he picks up. And it is very clear that if we go and live in another place where our mother tongue is not the main medium of communication, in the sense if you go to other states in our country, or if you go to the foreign countries, you will of course pick up the language very easily without having any the classroom teaching learning activities. So the title itself is revealing how audio means hearing, that is listening, is very important to pick up a language. And then hearing, if you keep on hearing to one particular language, you can be able to speak, provided if you give a methodical approach in that. So maybe noticing all the cognitive abilities of the children as well as the learners, adult learners or child learners, they might have, language experts might have designed this method, which is called as audiolingual method. And it has a particular, genesis, a point of genesis, which we'll be discussing in the next slide. So where we find the genesis of this method. Audiolingual method was developed in US, United States of America, especially during the Second World War. what happened at that time? Let us see. At that time, the US government found it a great necessity to set up a special language training program to supply the war with language personnel. So as the World War, it has the name itself reveals that it is not taking place at one area. And army of US, of course, even India and Europe, especially England and other armies are fighting at different places. At such circumstances, when US soldiers are placing from one particular place where English is not the language, they might have observed the need of the language personnel. So, therefore, the government of US commissioned American universities to develop foreign language program for military personnel. So, they observed the need that these military people should be able to learn the foreign language very quickly. And in that necessity, okay, actually the genesis of the audiolingual method took place. You know, as with the saying goes that necessity is the mother of invention. So there, during the World War II, the American soldiers felt that maybe these soldiers, you know, officers in the soldiers have intimated this to the government, and the government felt the need of a language personnel, and how best and how quick this army people can pick up another language. At this juncture, the genesis of the audiolingual method is noticed. So the American government, after realizing the seriousness, actually has introduced a program which is called as Army Specialized Training Program, ASTP, in 1942. So what are the objectives of this program? The objectives of this program is to make the students to attain conversational proficiency in a variety of foreign languages. See, so Army Specialized Training Program. So because armed people, army soldiers will be going to different places of the world, and they might be waging war, and when they are waging war from different places, there might be a need to learn that local language. That is why the US government started teaching the foreign language, and they aimed at the conversational proficiency. It is not like as grammar translation method says, like the writing accuracy or pronouncing the sound accurately, and then grammar, etc. But it is the conversational proficiency. So this is this was the need of the hour then. Okay, during the World War period, of course, for any language, conversational proficiency is the need of the hour. And as we can notice it even now among our circles or in other parts of the world also, how English language, when it is being taught as a foreign language, which we know it is being aimed that all learners should get conversational proficiency, which in turn we can say communication skills in that particular language. So the necessity of the developing communication skills for the armed personnel is what made the invention of this audiolingual method. Okay, the method used was known as the informant method. Informant, inform. Okay, since it is used a native speaker of the language, the informant. So only native speakers will be very effective in the conversational proficiency of their language, the mother tongue. You know, it is very much understood that whatever language you learn as a second language or a foreign language, you will be very convenient to speak in your mother tongue only. So naturally, if that ability comes, because we pick up the language as a social phenomena when from our childhood, and it gets imbibed into our system, cognitive system, so much that we will not fumble to utter a word in a given situation in the mother tongue. So these people have taken the native speakers as the informant and a linguist. The informant served as a source of language for imitation. So for linguists who are employed to teach these soldiers, the informant, who is the native speaker, you know, used to serve as the source of language. And the linguist is used to supervise the learning experience, how these people are learning. The intensive system adopted by the army achieved excellent results. You know, how this intensive system of using the informant and the linguist actually gave a very spectacular results or excellent results that they were very much impressed by this, and armed personnel could get the language skills, the foreign skills also. Actually, this is also known as army method also, because of this Genesis within the wartime period, perhaps it is known as the war, the army method also. Okay, then what is the base for developing this? Actually, this identification that the native speaker, if he is the informant or she is the informant, the foreign speakers, will learn the language very quickly. This has the base in the behaviorist psychology only. So we have seen behaviorism, an approach to English language teaching, how behaviorist psychology helped the development of behaviorism we have seen, and what is behaviorism, that is the observable behavior, that is noticeable behavior, etc. So this behaviorist psychology is the base behind the development of the audio linguism, or audio lingual method. See, the learning theory of audio lingualism is behavioral psychology. Of course, what is it that behavioral psychology is saying? It is an empirically based approach to the study of human behavior. So behavioralist psychology is an empirically based approach. You know, it is experimented and found out that it is the study of human behavior. And behaviorism tries to explain how an external event, a stimulus, caused a change in the behavior of an individual, a response. If you recollect my lecture on behaviorism, you can just go back to this concept of SR, you know, which are taken as stimulus response. Behaviorism, actually explains that language learning actually is, in between the stimulus and response. What is the external event and how we are responding to that? So without using concepts like mind or ideas, actually we have seen all this as part of behaviorism. Behaviorism will not stress upon the concepts of idea or mind or any kind of mental behavior, rather, but it stresses only on the obvious or evident or the behavior which is noticeable, which is observable only. Okay, so behaviorist psychology states that people are conditioned to learn many forms of behavior, including language. So behaviorist psychology considers language also as a behavior. Actually, how you develop your behavior, you know, that is by imitating or by through your environment, etc. So in the similar manner, how we develop different habits or different working styles or different responses that we give in a particular situation, etc., they are all based upon the behavioralist patterns that we observe in an environment, in a given environment. So these behaviorist psychologists believed that language is also a kind of behavior. That is why if the learners are placed in that kind of behavior, in a particular linguistic behavior, they will automatically gain the language, that is the knowledge of the language. Of course, learning a language is pertaining to LSRW skills, as you know. So if you are placed in a particular linguistic behavior, automatically you will be getting the first two very naturally, that is listening and speaking, through the process of training or conditioning. So if a certain kind of conditioning and training is given, it will be more effective. And it is, you know, in the absence of training or conditioning also, you can observe that though not as fast as it happens in this method, naturally, if people go and locate themselves in a different linguistic behavior than their mother tongue, they will automatically pick up. But it may take some time. Okay, but here we audiolingual method is designed so to reduce the time. You know, it was a war situation, is a very emergent, urgent situation where things should be taken up very speedily. So they actually observed this and they tried to focus on how best and how quickly the foreign learners can take up another language. So the base, the whole base of audiolingual method is in the behaviorist psychology only. So what are the basic principles? You know, they are like, you know, the basic principles behind, let me correct my slide. Okay, the basic principles is separation of language skills into listening, speaking, reading and writing. You know, nowadays we use this LSRW with facility, but at that time this was actually as a principle of audiolingual method it started. The basic principle is like separating the skills of the language into these four kinds and with emphasis on the teaching of listening and speaking before reading and writing. So the audiolingual method emphasizes on the teaching of listening and speaking. Okay, and then what is the other principle? Use of dialogues. You know, dialogues are used actually. Dialogues are used as the chief means of presenting the language. How can you present the language to the learner? It is through dialogues only. You know, you might have gone through some exercises on dialogue writing, especially in your intermediate or degree, and that is actually intended to give you more command upon the language only. If you are able to coin the dialogue or write the dialogue between the imagined situations which you face in the real life, like going to the bank manager and requesting him to open a bank account, or going to, asking a dialogue between a stranger and a man on the road, you know, two strangers who is seeking an address, etc. Or a dialogue between the doctor and the patient, or a dialogue, between a mother and daughter in an imagined situation, etc. So like this, use of dialogues, you know, dialogue writing is always considered as a technique of improving the speaking as well as writing skills, but the main focus is first on the speaking. And next, emphasis on certain practice techniques, which are actually like the drills, practice like mimicry, memorization and pattern drills, and then discouraging the use of mother tongue in the classroom. And then what are the objectives? Let us see what are the objectives of this method. The general objective of this method is to enable the learner to learn the target language communicatively. It is not through writing, or it is not through grammar, or it is not like directly using the language in the classroom, but it is through communication. And of course, the other object is training in listening comprehension. Audios audio cassettes will be played and you will be asked to listen to the comprehension, accurate pronunciation. You have to get the pronunciation from that and then reading comprehension also. And then the other objective is development of mastery in all four language skills, as it is the basic principle of this. And then develop in the students the same types of abilities that native speakers have. Okay, whatever the native speaker is having as a linguistic ability, this method aims to give or aims to provide the student those techniques which will enable him to talk like a native speaker. You know, talk in the sense not just imitating the native speakers, but to have an immediate response. Okay, very automatically, without stopping to think. You know, whether this happens or not, it is a different matter. But if you keep on speaking naturally, sometimes, after some time, you will stop thinking or fumbling for the words. So this is the main objective of this method. And next, we have a list of techniques that are used to bring in this effectiveness in language learning, especially listening and speaking. So I have a list of the techniques like here, which are put in the red color. You can see first repetition drill. So what happens in this? Repeating the teacher's model. You know, teachers will be saying some words and ask the students to repeat. Okay, or they may give a sentence pattern and ask the student to repeat, changing the subject or object or verbs like that. So it can be, anything. Okay, so repeating whatever the teacher is doing is what is the repetition drill. And it gives us repeatedly, if you are learning one thing, naturally you will get a command on that. Then substitution drill, it is repeating the line from the dialogue, substituting the given cues into the line in its proper place. So some lines will be given and other words will be given, and these words have to be inserted into the dialogue at an appropriate place only. Okay, then question and answer drill. Actually, this drill gives students practice with answering questions as well as asking questions. You know, unless you know how to ask a question, you are not, fluent in that language. So that is why students are encouraged to ask questions in this. That is why question and answer drill is there. It is repeated. A drill is nothing but doing the things repeatedly. And this drill actually gives us the practice of answering questions as well as asking questions also. And the next techniques we have, expansion drill. That means to expand, okay, the main structure, the produce longer sentence bit by bit, gradually achieving fluency. And the main structure is repeated first, then students have to put cue phrase in its proper place. So main structure is given and again another cue is given, and then students are asked to expand that. And clause combination, combining two simple sentences into a complex one. This drill is also given using many different types of examples. And background build-up drill or back chaining. It is also called as back chaining. And this is used when a long line of dialogue is giving students trouble. You know, if the students are not able to understand or remember a big dialogue, a long dialogue, this is used. The teacher breaks down the line into several parts and the students repeat a part of sentence, usually the last phrase of the line. Okay, that is why it is called background build-up drill. Okay, we have touched the 6 out of 9 and the rest 3 are like a chain drill. So what is this? This is a drill that gets its name from the chain of conversation. You know, a teacher first converses with a student and then stops at one point of time, and then the student has to continue his conversation with his fellow student. and then that fellow student with his next fellow student, like that. So it goes on, the chain of conversation goes on, and this is you know, a practice, a drill, so that learners will get more language more effectively. So the teacher begins the chain by greeting a particular student or asking him a question, and then the student who was you know, asked the question has to ask the question the fellow student. So this is how the chain goes on. And completion, students hear an utterance that is complete except for one word. So incomplete words, words are uttered leaving out the final syllable, etc., and or like that, and they have, the students have to complete the word. This is the completion. And the use of minimal pairs. So what is this? The teacher works with pairs of words which differ in only one sound. The teacher gives one such example of words which a pair which is differing only in one sound. The students are encouraged to you know, come up with so many minimal pairs like that. So this is how the 9 techniques of drill, you know, how repeatedly the students are advised to do the drill, or with the encouragement of the teacher, they will be you know, practiced in a drill. And all these 9 techniques are used by audiolingual method, so to make the language learning very effective. So finally, you know, before concluding, I just want to refer to some point, that is, what are the advantages of this method. You know, it is believed that because it is developed during the later first half of the 20th century only, though it is almost the middle of the century, it is the first method to have a theory base, which is the behavioralist theory, behaviorist psychological theory. And then it made the language teaching possible for larger groups of learners, as it was experimented with the army personnel. And it emphasizes sentence production, control over grammatical structures, and development of oral ability. Actually, if you keep on speaking a particular language, your grammatical mistakes will also be reduced automatically, because by speaking or by drilling, automatically you will get the command, such a command that you will not commit a mistake. See, for example, if you know the rule, like you know what you say, take for example tenses, and then you have in the simple present tense for the third person singular pronouns, you have to add yes or es to the verb, you know, he likes or she likes or it likes, etc., or they like, etc. So only for the singular pronouns of third person we have to add in the simple present tense s or es to the verb. This is the rule when you learn the tenses. Okay, to learn the rule is a different matter, but when you speak, yeah, fluid, you know, again and again using these forms, you know, he likes apples, or she likes guavas, or he likes to walk, and etc. Many examples are constructed on that naturally. Or if you keep on speaking in the present simple tense, you will never you know, miss adding the s or es, or you will never add s or es where it is not applicable. So that is what is the you know, continuous speaking or sentence production actually brings a control over the grammatical structures. So I have given this example because it is a very familiar example where we commit tense mistakes in the tense occurs in the simple present tense. Okay, so if you keep drilling on this aspect, and if you keep uttering these sentences and use these sentences again in your speech also, you will avoid you know, committing mistakes. And unconsciously, you need not be consciously put some effort to avoid mistakes, but if the drill enables you to avoid those mistakes very unconsciously. Okay, then what is this? Developing simple techniques and making use of language lab. It has simple techniques like we have seen 9 techniques of repetition drill or back chain drill or substitution drill, etc. So many other drills which can be used in the language laboratory, English language laboratory, with the aid of some kind of software. Okay, developing the separation of the language skills. LSRW skills were separated and these were developed actually. In the sequence also, okay. These are the advantages, and let us see finally disadvantages. Though it people say that though it has a basis of theory, it is a weak basis. Yet whether it is weak or not, even audiolingual method, is not the final answer for what you say teaching the foreign language. As I have told you in the introduction itself, method after method or approach after approach have taken place or dominated the history of English language teaching. It is not because one method is good or the other method is bad, but it is because every method will have its own weaknesses or strong points. Only thing is, some people may like to use some method, or in some situations or at some places one method may be more suitable than the other, etc. So the language teacher has to very dynamic in designing his materials and the methods or approaches to be followed while instruction is being given. So people considered that though it has a theoretical base, it is weak to some certain extent, and then it is not developing language competency and a lack of effectiveness and boredom caused by endless pattern drills. Again and again, students are made to practice the drills, and some experts felt that this may bring a monotonous tone, and then students may get bored of these drills. And then learners having little control over their learning, because it is only through the informant and through the audios, etc. Learners may not be able to influence their learning. And then teachers' domination of the class. Of course, they have to follow the teacher for all the guidances in doing the drills and all. Okay. And then all the materials that were developed in the audiolingual method were criticized as being teacher-oriented materials. You know, perhaps without a teacher, you may not be able to learn it. Okay. So when we have this, learning languages in 30 days or 60 days, etc. And then self-learning tools are also have come up. So in such situations, people felt that this is ineffective. This method is ineffective because all the materials will be used only with the help of the teacher. So they are all teacher-oriented materials. Okay, this is what I have to share regarding the audiolingual method. If you have any doubts, you can just share through WhatsApp also, or when you come to the class tomorrow, you can discuss there also. Okay. I hope you have followed whatever I have explained regarding the audiolingual method. As far as I can simplify, I did that. I request you to listen to this lecture again and again, so that you will be able to understand this method thoroughly. Okay, have a nice time.